Good afternoon and welcome to the Vicarage. I'm in the kitchen at the moment for our time of prayer and praise together. We were unable to sing earlier today in church, so we're going to have some hymns to sing now and the sermon. So a sort of cafe style praise, if you like. I'm going to make myself a cup of coffee. If you get yourself comfortable, we're going to spend a little bit of time together in worship and in praise. It's not the nicest weather outside. It's not the blazing sunshine we had a few days ago or a couple of weeks ago, but we're going to begin with our first hymn. It's a hymn I found myself singing to myself as I walked the dogs around the lime pits during that blazing sunshine. It's a beautiful hymn. We're going to sing it now. All creatures of our God and King, and let's prepare ourselves for worship. Okay, so I hope you've had a bit of a sing-along and annoyed the neighbours. Let's hear again the reading from a little earlier today, the Gospel of Matthew. So Matthew chapter 11, verses 16 to 19, and then verses 25 to 30. And it said this: At that time Jesus said, To what will I compare this generation?
It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn. For John came, neither eating nor drinking, and they say he has a demon. The Son of Man came, eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son of Man chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And so before we look a little bit deeper at that reading, let's have another hymn. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. Let's have the Lord of the Dance. And so for just a few moments, let's look again a little bit at that reading. We play- played the flute for you. You did not dance. We wailed. You did not mourn. Jesus is uniting his ministry with that of John the Baptist. John the Baptist wailed as he called people to repentance, and they would not listen. Jesus came piping the dance as he feasted with tax collectors and sinners, but people wouldn't rejoice. At least many of them would not. And both parts of that were needed. We need the time of wailing to prepare us for the time of feasting, to strip away all that's holding us back, to be open for the celebration of the bridegroom in the coming of Jesus Christ. And Jesus is using children to teach us. But the position of children back then was very different to children today. They were seen as little adults. They were expected to work, not just to be another mouth to feed. And yet Jesus uses these people, who are often seen as a burden on others until they're old enough and capable enough to bring in income or labour into the family unit. Jesus uses them to teach us. What is it we can learn from children? And I think the first thing is their openness. Children show their emotions, they don't hide them. They're either screaming in a tantrum on the floor, or they're laughing hysterically. We see that in playgrounds all the time. Jesus is talking about the unresponsiveness of people to the message of the good news of the kingdom of God. When John the Baptist came telling them how far they were removed from that kingdom, they should have wept, and they didn't. And when Jesus came with open arms to invite them in to feast with him, they should have rejoiced and laughed and danced, but they didn't. Jesus calls us to be like children, not childish, but childlike, to be open, to be responsive, and to respond to him with all our heart, with all our emotion, with every part of ourselves, and to let that be seen. Let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and glorify your kingdom, your Father in heaven. Rejoice and let it be seen. Doesn't mean we walk along with fixed smiles on our faces, but we rejoice with an indescribable joy, that knowledge all is well if we walk with him. Children have that openness that we as adults often lose, and we cover up for the sake of respectability and also for social convention, so we don't hurt or offend the sensibilities of others. Yet Jesus calls us to respond to him with all our heart, to weep with those who weep, to rejoice with those who rejoice, and to walk with him. And children have an honesty. They don't hide what they are. They just are. And again, we often lose that as adults. And children have an irrepressible hopefulness. I remember when I was at infant school, standing under the veranda at playtime, and it was chucking it down with rain, and all the school were gathered under the veranda. It went all round the courtyard. And we'd sing a chant of rain, rain, go away, come again another day. We all had a hope that the rain would disappear before playtime was over. Children always have a hopefulness, no matter how dark it may be. There's that hope that the toy will arrive at Christmas, that the ice cream man will come. There's always that hopefulness, and Jesus calls us to be people of hope. For hope does not disappoint us. We hope in Christ, who has the answer of it all. Come, learn of me. My yoke is easy. The yoke is there to enable us to carry the burden of life more easily. The yoke is there to make life more tolerable. And what is that yoke he offers? To learn of him, to walk with him, to be with him, and being with him, to dance with him, to rejoice in the knowledge of the kingdom. Amen. And so we are called to weep with those who weep, to laugh with those who laugh, those two parts, both are required, meekness and majesty, both parts of Christ's mission, our next hymn. So perhaps it's a time for us to pray, a time to draw close to God, mindful of that rest he offers us, not taking away the burdens of the day, but making them easier to bear because of his invitation, come, learn of me, be with me. Walking alongside him, we can bear anything, we can face anything. And our prayers today are musical prayers, another hymn, the words hopefully you'll be able to read. And open your heart to God. If you have a candle, you might like to light it, if it's safe for you to do so. Or just sit and listen or read the words along to the tune and open our hearts to God, who comes to bring rest, to bring relief, to bring us the joy of the bridegroom, that we may dance with him. And so let us pray.
Thank you.
so we end. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all and those whom we love, this day and always. Amen. And we end in the knowledge that the Spirit comes to set us free. Our final hymn.
Light will shine for all to see.